Hi folks, Larry here, Mobile Tech with CannedHamTrailers.com. And today I've got a special treat for you. That's right, I'm going to take you trailer hunting with me. Now in the past you've all heard me talk about how I find my trailers. Sometimes I find them along the side of the road, out in the deserts. In a lot of my exploring videos you see that I find trailers. Most of the time I find them in people's yards. So fasten your seat belts, I'm going out trailer hunting, and I'm taking you with me. I'm about, 15 miles from my house, and I go by this place all the time and I never noticed this before, but this is a little tiny trailer park. As you can see here, very tiny. It's on 208. And there's a general store here. It's called the Buckboard. The fire department is across the street. I'm heading that way, but I never noticed this. How did I never notice this thing? This thing's about 3 feet long and a couple of feet tall. Looks like it's been here a long time. I don't think it was just put here or anything. Yeah, it's been here a long time, but how cute. So I had to stop, turn around, and come back here and photograph it. There's an older trailer way in the back there, but that's the only one that's older. There's somebody there, so somebody stays in it, I guess. There it is. Not sure what it is. It's like an 80s trailer. But that's just cuter than a Dickens. You've got a spare tire in the back. When I'm trailer hunting, or even when I'm ever driving anywhere, I keep my eyes open. I don't want to run off the road, but I do keep my eyes open. Got my head on a swivel. Out here in rural Nevada, you look for communities. There are little communities strewn all over the place out in these wide open spaces. Once in a while, I'll spot something. And if I've got the time, I'll take off on a road, like one of these, and I'll just drive around and see what there is to see. Not only do I get to know the area really well, but every once in a while, I spot an old canned ham sitting around. I'm gonna stop by that house on the way back from breakfast, because last week I spotted an old canned ham and I found the owner, and that house is where that owner lives. I left my card with his wife, but he never called me back. So you got to be persistent sometimes. They're not thinking, oh yeah, I'm going to sell that canned ham trailer, get rid of it. Sometimes they're just not thinking that. They're too busy. So on the way back from breakfast, I'll go ahead and stop there. There's also another place I was roaming around, and I'll show you that one. But I talked to the owner, and he's a pretty old guy, and he doesn't want to sell it. I don't know why, but he doesn't want to sell it. You might look at 5, 10, 15 trailers. You might find the owners for half of them, and then you're lucky if one of them wants to sell. Don't know why that is. I think a lot of people have stuff stored in them and they just don't want to lose the storage space. And I've thought of offering them a new shed in trade for the trailer. If I could get them a shed for $500 or $600, maybe even $1,000, Then they might want to trade. That way they don't lose their storage space. I'll try that sometime and see how it works. Next time I get that excuse, I'll try and see how it works. This little community is one that I haven't hit yet. Topaz Ranch Estates, I think it's called, or something. I might drive around this a little bit on the way back. You see lots of trailers out here. Lots and lots of people have trailers. But you gotta be able to quickly pick out the canned hams, because that's pretty much all I'm really interested in. I'm not interested in, oh, you know, like aristocrat toasters. By toaster, I mean a square trailer. And I'm also not interested in tube trailers like the Argosies. You see one over there. Or the Airstreams. Not really interested in those. So I've learned to differentiate while I'm moving. Yeah, I think we'll drive around this community when I come back. That's Topaz Lake. And we're going to historical and famous Topaz Lodge for breakfast. Topaz Lodge and Casino. Driving around this community and not really seeing anything yet. I just started. Looking off, trying to see if I see anything with the right shape. Nothing yet. Actually not seeing as many trailers here as I normally do in places like this. Trailers of any kind, any age. But we'll keep looking. Haven't seen anything at all of interest yet. A lot of newer trailers, a couple of old motorhomes, but nothing I'm interested in. Well, on a quick run through this community, just on the main drag, I didn't see anything. I'll have to come back when I got a little more time and go off on some of the other streets, some of the connector streets in between, because I just did a cruise through the main drag and didn't see anything. But you never know, there might be something back there. Now I'm gonna go bug the people, Bill and his wife, about the trailer that I saw last week. I think it's a 59 or a 60 DeVille, just from the shape and the looks and the way the windows are and the way the wheel wells are. That's what it looks like to me. I'll go bug him again, see if she gave my card to her husband Bill, and see what happened. There's something you don't see everywhere. Well, there's nobody home. I left my card again. And we'll see if they give me a call. I'm persistent, if nothing else. I go by here probably once every week or so. And I met the wife last week and gave her my card. I'll just keep stopping by until I get either a flat out no, I don't want to sell it, or a yes. Now, it's amazing that I even spotted this old trailer, but right there, I don't know if you can see it. Just the top of it is showing. I can't zoom in because I'm driving. But let's go see. Yeah, here's the road. I mean, only the very top of it was showing. And I wasn't sure, so I came back and took a second look, and sure enough, it was a Can-Am. So you really have to keep your eyes open. Now this is down the old man's driveway quite a ways, so I think I can stop and photograph it from the outside without bothering him, because there's nothing he can tell me. But it's really hidden, see? There it is, right there. See it? Right there. I'm just gonna, not even gonna pull into his driveway. It's number 10, I guess. Yeah, his house is way up there. I'm just gonna sort of pull over here. Try not to get stuck. It's probably fairly rotten inside because it's been sitting out here. We don't get that much snow, so I don't think the roof has caved in from snow loads, but it does have a good sized dent up there. Right there. Those kind of dents cannot be repaired. But I'm thinking 59 or 60 DeVille. It might not be a DeVille, but oh, wait a minute. It is a DeVille. See? Yep. Do I know my trailers? And the handle's gone. A screwdriver would get me in there. Tires. It's going to need new tires before I even move it. That's for sure. Can't see inside because it's got old curtains. So there's really no way to see inside. I wonder when the last time it was registered was. Quite a while ago from what it looks like here. But yeah, I would love to have this trailer. Yeah, this is going to be a 60 or 61, actually, I think, because of the tail lights. And it's custom Mesa on the lower, well, all of it. Yeah, it's custom Mesa, 2-inch custom Mesa metal. Most of it's in pretty good shape. It's got the old filler. Looks like it had dual tanks at one time. Oh, there's the old handle to open it with. And that's actually a garage door handle. It's not the real one. Ooh. I can see a little bit in there. Oops, getting water on my camera here. But it is in pretty rough shape, as she said. Pretty beat up is the way she put it. But I would love to have it. And yeah, that dent, it's going to need a new roof. Let's put it that way. So I'll take some pictures. And I will go back to his house again. Maybe during the week would be a better time. So. So this next one, I don't know what it is, but I have a funny feeling that the guy that owns it was a sheep herder. And because sheep herders all live in trailers. I guess he's retired now and has a place to live in. But when they're herding their sheep, they're usually living in a trailer. And this next one that we're going to go look at, I think that's what it was, sheep herder's trailer, number one. I think that because it's got a chimney stack coming out of it. And so it's got a little fireplace inside, or a little stove, a wood-burning stove or something. Anyway, we'll go by there, and I'll just, so I already talked to the guy, he doesn't want to sell it. That's probably why. It's probably nostalgic to him, you know. Some things people just don't want to sell. When he dies, maybe his kids will sell it. And I've seen that happen. I chased a trailer for 5 years, trying to get an old 47 Trotwood, trying to get the lady to sell it to me, and she wouldn't do it. And then finally she died, and her daughter sold it to us for $50. And I didn't get it. Ooh, 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 what is that? Oh, darn. Oh, that's it, okay. From here, I can see the trailer I want to show you. It's way over there. So, I had come down this road just to see what was down it because of the name of the road, which is also the name of a mine, an old mining town. And that's really the reason I came down this road. But along the way, I spotted a little round trailer. And it's where where this purple house is. There it is. And that looks like a Westerner. Let's see if I can get close enough to take, yeah. That looks like a Westerner, a 57. Let's see if I can zoom in on that baby. Yeah, see the sideways front windows? That's why I think it's a Westerner. That's the only trailer I've seen with those. There it is. And can you see it's got a little chimney stack coming out of it? Maybe it's not a Westerner. Yeah, I didn't get close enough. Yeah, it might not be a Westerner. That's not the type of windows I thought it had. The front side windows, if they're sideways pushouts, air pushouts, then it's a Westerner, but I think those are jealousy. I'm not sure. But as you can see, going down these roads, there it is. Okay, I'm gonna take some pictures. I'm a long distance away from it, and I don't want to bother the guy, but I'm gonna take some pictures. Yeah, it's not a Westerner. It's got jealousy side front windows. It's got that smokestack on there. He's probably removed a seat. Might have removed the whole dinette, who knows. But yeah, I have a funny feeling. And the guy lives in that house. Where is it? Jeez, can't see anything here. There it is. Lives right there, right in that house. And yeah, that would be a good candidate, whatever it is. Don't know what it is though. So judging from the looks of that trailer, it's a 1959, 60 or 61. There it is. So you really got to keep your eyes open. Find these things. They're out there though. You're not seeing too many of this era on the Craigslist anymore or on eBay unless they've already been quote unquote restored. So I recommend you do your hunting in the rural areas. I mean, I found them in cities too, but usually, you know, they're hard to see in cities. You got buildings in the way everywhere and walls, so they're hard to spot. Out in the rural areas, a little easier to spot, even when they're hidden. Just drive around. Keep your eyes open. Now I spotted this old trailer a while back, probably a couple years ago. And I had to search, go home and search on Google Earth on how to get to where it is. And there was nobody home when I knocked on the door, so I left my card with a note saying that I was interested in buying it, but I never heard from them. Now, you never know where you're going to find an old trailer. This thing looks like it has definitely seen better days. Yeah, there isn't much left of that one. I wonder what's inside of it. Now, this is on an old piece of property that has looks like it hasn't been maintained in forever. So the only way to find the owner here is to go look up records down there at the county office and find out who owns it and contact them. But from the looks of it, this one probably isn't worth the trouble. I'm going to see if I can get a little closer without getting arrested. The brush on this side of the fence is just way too thick. I'd be a lot better off just hopping the fence and seeing if I could get over to that trailer just to see what's inside. It's probably gutted. There used to be another one, I think it was a Westerner, that was over on another road, and I stopped, talked to the people, went out and looked at it. It was completely gutted. Didn't even have a single window in it, so it was worthless. This one probably is the same way. Look at that thing. Yeah, there's not much left of that one. I don't really want to jump over the fence because it's private property. And there's probably nothing inside. It's probably gutted. There's an odd little one. Saw that from way out on the road. Had to walk over here and get a look at it. But it's nothing I want to deal with. Looks like a European trailer. Now here's a trailer that I've had my eye on for the last few years. This whole area has been ransacked already by a lady named Dorothy, who did a lot of vintage trailer flipping. So by the time I got here, a lot of it was already gone. At least all the low-hanging fruit, the stuff that's easily spottable. And she told me that she has talked to this guy numerous times and he'll have nothing to do with selling it. But now I finally stopped in and talked to the nice young lady who lives here. She's a tenant, and she says her landlord, the owner of this trailer, is thinking about getting rid of all the junk that's on this property. So I might have a chance at it. So I've talked to her, I've given her my card. I told her that there's a $100 finder's fee in it for her if I end up making a deal with this guy. So that motivates her to keep it on her mind and talk to him about it, which she says she'll do today. At any rate, if I do get it, I'll knock this fence down and back it out. I'll have to do something with the dirt around here, unless I can get it out through the front, but it looks like coming out through the back will be the best. And then I'll, of course, put the fence back up. You always want to guarantee people that you'll do no damage or that you'll repair whatever damage you do. I may even have to use the next door neighbor's property to get it out of here because there's a big ditch back here that I don't think I can back it through. Now this is a fairly good sized trailer. It looks to be 22 feet maybe. It's got two doors and both of them are missing the handles. Perhaps the handles are inside. Maybe they were saved. Don't know. It's also got that on top awning there, awning rail there, which always means that that wall leaked. It's a 1940s trailer. I can tell by the shape, the way it's built, and by these windows. These are steel windows, not aluminum. When they get really bad, they're harder to rebuild, but these look like they're in pretty good shape. So that shouldn't be a problem. It's a stick-built trailer, I can tell that. It will be built a lot like, possibly like the 47 mainline I'm working on. I hope it's not a solid plywood trailer. I'd rather see framed walls. Don't really want to do another solid plywood trailer, to be honest with you. Now, it doesn't have any tail lights other than the one down there for the license plate light and the stop light. No turn indicators, and they've never been added like what happened to the 47 mainline. So it's probable that this trailer has been here for a very, very long time. I noticed on the other side that the running lights, the marker lights, were missing on the sides. But on this side, they're here. And this window has been open for as long as I've been here. So I imagine it's been well aired out over the years, but also some water probably got in there due to the broken window and the winds that we have when we have rains. It looks like it's a framed trailer. I can see right there. I can see right there where that water line is sticking out, that there's airspace in there. So it's probably framed, and that's a good thing. All the windows are here. And that's a good thing too. It's got teardrop wheel wells. That's cool. So now really all we can do is wait and see if we hear from Brittany. And Brittany, if you're watching, I want to thank you for at least trying if this doesn't work out. But this is how I find my trailers. I may visit 10, 15, or 20 trailers before I get a hit on one of them. Other times, very first time I visited a trailer in this area, I bought it. That was the 1961 Aljo. And I flipped it for a nice profit. But now the way trailers are starting to get so rare, vintage ones anyway, kind of wish I'd have kept it. Now you want to remember at all times to respect people's privacy and respect their private property. Don't go barging into somebody's backyard. Don't be peeking over the fence with a camera. You might get shot. You just never know in places like this. I'm in very rural Nevada here, and things are different than they are in the big cities. I'll be sure to continue on with this series. I hope you really like it. If you do, give me a thumbs up, will you? It really helps with my YouTube stuff. And remember, I'm Mobile Tech Larry from CanhamTrailers.com, and I make mistakes so you don't have to. We'll see you all next time, and happy trailer hunting.